Folks, before you start hanging and banging, I wonder if you could reflect upon the recent turn of events here in the WWF with you and Paul Orndorff.
Reflect, yeah, man, I can reflect. All the good times we had together, the times we trained day in and out, pushed ourselves to the limit. You know, Paul Orndorff, I even can remember our families, brother, breaking bread together, Thanksgiving especially. And yeah, man, I can reflect and remember the oath, man, the oath you and I made, dude, to take it all the way to the top. And if for some reason we fell off track, we swore as blood brothers we'd go down together, man. Yeah, I can see it all now. I can remember. Yeah, I've heard Orndorff wired before, but nothing like he was when he reached me at the gym. You know, he sounded unreasonable, almost incoherent. But you know, when he asked me to stand behind him against Bundy and Stud, I said, Paul, I'll be there all the way. Man, what a fool. You can see it right there. Despite the fact that Orndorff was a one-man gang on an ego trip in the Moondogs match, that was okay with me. We had one more week, man. 1 week to get ready for the big one, Stud and Bundy. A whole week. The next day, I even flew to Tampa to make it easier on him. But all he wanted to do was argue. And then when he pulled a disappearing act in T-Town for 3 days, I didn't know where he was hiding out. The only thing he had the courtesy to do was leave a note for me, saying I'll see you at the arena. Man, what a fool I was. You know, I actually thought this dude needed some space to clear his head out, man. Just a little time. So I gave it to him. But then when I saw him on that night, the night of Stud and Bundy, the worst nightmare I ever wanted to see, I was worried because Orndorff, nothing had changed with you, man. Nothing.
Take care of business.
Yeah, man, when the match started, you know, I thought Orndorff would forget about what was bothering him. And then finally, after Stud and Bundy beat me to a pulp, man, yeah, you came in. You finally came in. You sold out, man. You swore to me you'd never take shortcuts. You took the biggest shortcut of your life, Orndorff, Mr. Wonderful. You were on the verge of greatness, man. You had a whole generation of little hucksters training with you, man. Saying prayers with you, dude. Eating their vitamins with you, man. And you sold them out. You didn't sell me out, brother, because you can't take me. I took your best shot, man, when I was down. Now I'm going to return that favor. But just like those spies, man, in Washington, today who are selling our country out for diamonds, gold, ego, greed. Jealousy, man. That's just what you are, Orndorff. You sold out a country, man. You sold out all those people that believed in you, man. Cheap shots. Shortcuts. You make me sick, Wonderful. You'll never beat Hulkamania, man. I got a whole generation, man, that's gonna live forever because of this thought. Positive thoughts, that is. And we don't take shortcuts, dude. You know, I can even think every time you stuck your hand out to shake my hand, there was that thin film of perspiration coming off your palm that separated us as brothers, man. That separated us. The jealousy separated us between brotherhood. That's what it was. Orndorff, Hulkamania's got time. I got patience, brother. I ain't gonna take no cheap shot to take you down, dude. I'm gonna set you up and take you out for good, man. And all I got to say, those big wheels of Hulkamania, those big stones, man, they're gonna grind you up, man. But they grind ever so slow.